Welcome to the second tutorial of Introduction to Statistics. Today, we will discuss some difficult aspects of measures of center and spread of distributions, such as mean variance standard deviations. Key questions: how do I remember all these formulas? How do I understand these formulas? How do I use formulas fluently without tension and anxiety, and how I apply those formulas in real life or for my assignments? And indicators of learning will be: did you organize your formulas? Did you discuss the meaning of these formulas with others? Did you type the formulas with Excel, in the PowerPoint, in your discussion board, and so on and so forth? Typing formulas is one way to understand and remember them. Did you solve all problems at the back of the book? Today we will learn how to type formulas such as division of two variables or two terms, expressions, exponential notation, how to type root square or x bar, which is very important. First of all, organize your formulas and organize them well. This is my way of organization of formulas. I use population column and column for symbols of sample. The mean for population is the Greek letter mu, the mean of sample is the Latin letter x bar usually, and we can use y bar and everything else. Deviation from mean: every value has some deviation from the mean. As we will see, all deviations from the mean, if you add them, will give always zero. The mean is value that divides the values in the distribution in two pieces, one which is above the mean and the other piece that is under the mean. But deviation from the mean is overlooked frequently. Formula x minus mu: you square all deviations because the sum is always zero of deviations. Finding the average deviation would be always zero. So we square all deviation, we add them, divide by the total number of cases, and this is the variance of our values around the mean, or variance of our values from sample would be divided by n minus 1. You know, this is a little correction for the fact that when we select fewer cases, we kind of miss a little bit of the variability in our distribution. Then root square of the variance is very important characteristic of distribution around the mean called standard deviation. Root square of fraction: on the top you have the sum of all squared deviations, on the bottom you have n. You see how it goes very fluently one after another on a vertical line, and how easy it is to remember that the formulas are almost identical. The difference is n minus 1. The other difference is the mu or x bar. Mu, average for the population, x bar, average for the sample. And that's all for my tutorial with PowerPoint. Now let's see how all this looks with Excel. Excel is allowing us to do some calculation. And in Excel, you get the formula, and now this formula will make sense because we will make the calculations of and will demonstrate now how to use this formula for calculations. So first we have our data, x. Oftentimes students wonder, what exactly is x? X are all values of our variable. The mean is actually the sum of all values, so I put sum and I select all values. Excel will organize the range of all values from M4 to M14 and will divide by 10. This is my the mean of my values. And I did a little mistakes. I first summed them. So when I do the mean, I will have to get the sum of all values, but without the sum of the values, because I will double the value of mean. So from M4 to M14 divided by 10, and that's the mean. The deviation from the mean, actually, let me show you how to type formula with Excel. Deviation from the mean, Excel will put the formula bar somewhere, and we want this to be a little larger, like 20, probably 20 is more than enough, 20 is plenty. I will position this only in the bar, and I will start typing. It is, I will put in parentheses x minus, let's consider that we are working in this case with x bar, which means that I have sample. In to type x bar, you need to select a placeholder for x bar, which is this A with two dots. In different programs, you will have different ways to calculate. And then how to type squared deviations. For square deviations, you go insert, then you have to find your equation editor. Excel again will put the equation editor somewhere in the middle, which is very annoying, but typing formulas is not popular, so we have to do whatever we can do with whatever we have. So first I need the place value for exponent, and this is e to the x in my case. Then I will put the deviations from the mean, which is x minus x bar. Once again, x bar is this place value here. The third row, second column will give me x bar. Then I want to get out of the bar symbol, so I pressed one of the four arrows to the right, and then squared. Okay, this is how we type formulas. Now let's calculate all deviations from the mean. Sorry, let's go in the first deviation from the mean equals, and I will get 21 minus the mean, which is 32.200. Please put they call my students money symbol, put the dollar sign so that we can copy the formula. Position your mouse pointer on the lower left right corner, and all formulas are copied. Now let's see what is the sum of all deviations from the mean. I will put equal sum, and all deviations from the mean, the sum always is zero. This is what mean is all about. This is why I will square all deviations. We'll take the deviations to the power. This is shift, and 6 will give us this power sign, to the power of 2. And then I will copy this formula. You see how I position the mouse pointer? And of course, the sum of all numbers squared deviations is not zero. Let's see, it's a big number though. Can this be used as a spread? Well, in variance, after we sum all variations in the variance, I will divide all variations by the total number of cases minus 1, because this is variance in case of sample. And I would like to correct myself here. N minus 1 is the formula for the variance. So this is everything that is under the root square. If I, to calculate standard deviation, I have to get the variance, the square root of the variance. Make a little larger. equals the value of variance square root sqrt. This is the formula for square root of this value here, and my variance actually is this 16.10245. I also have formula to compare the standard deviation given directly from Excel. So I put ST deviation and close it, the range, and this formula is giving the standard deviation directly. Many programs and formulas are trying to help you to find the standard deviation, but it is always helpful to know what standard deviation is. So in this tutorial we learn how to type and how to use formulas for standard deviation and variance. We'll see you online. Thank you.